Hi, my name is Yuri Diorgis. I'm a senior program manager for CXE Security Team working with Azure Security Center. In today's video, we are going to talk about Azure Security Center's Secure Score and how to leverage the Secure Score to continuously improve in your secure posture. We are going to talk about the enhancement of the new model, the Secure Score model with Secure Controls, and how to leverage this new model to address different scenarios regarding Secure Score. We're gonna do a demonstration on how this model works, and we're going to draw some important best practices about the use of Secure Score.
So Azure Security Center, when you first onboard Azure Security Center in your subscription, and keep in mind your subscription will have multiple resources, storage account, VMs, Security Center is going to scan that subscription and identify those resources. It's going to verify the secure state of those resources and if everything is protected according to the secure best practice and secure recommendations, your secure score is going to be 100%. Reality is that most of customers are in this journey to improve their secure score. So when they onboard Security Center, they might find out that their secure score, the current secure score is actually 50%. So they want to continue progressing and have those checks. Could be weekly checks, monthly checks, right? To verify if they are progressing with the secure score. The idea is always to increase the secure score, because as you increase the secure score, you are actually dropping the amount of secure recommendations, okay? And you are increasing your secure posture. That's what you want to do. You want to make sure that you address all the secure hygiene recommendations available in Secure Center, that over time is going to lower the amount of recommendations and is going to automatically enhance your overall secure posture for your cloud workloads. Now, there is something very important to notice, that some customers on this journey to improve the secure score, they notice that as they add new resources to the subscription, new storage account, new VMs, what they've seen is a drop on secure score. And the reason why you have this drop sometimes is a big drop. It really depends on the amount of resources that you add to your subscription. It's because those resources were deployed in such a way that is not secure by default. In other words, they don't have good Azure governance to get the lesson learned from Azure Security Center and incorporate back into the beginning of the pipeline. The idea is that it's a life cycle. Right, so you address the security recommendation, you get the lesson learned, and you incorporate this back into your pipeline so that when you deploy new resources, you deploy already secure. And you use Azure policy, Azure blueprints as a way to enhance your Azure governance. That's really the only way that you're going to chase the secure score that not only is going to continue to grow, but it also be steady. As you add new resources, it's not going to negatively affect your secure score. So we are going to the demo environment to show how this new secure score model maps to this reality by using secure controls.
In Security Center main dashboard, you now have the new secure score model showing a percentage format. This helps you to understand where you are in your journey to address the secure recommendations, and your target will be 100%. If you have multiple subscriptions, you can click on the secure score itself and you will see the breakdown per subscription. Now, as far as remediating the recommendations, what you're going to do is you're going to go to the secure hygiene and click on recommendations, and you will see that the new secure score model is now organized in different secure controls. Make sure that you prioritize the top-down list, which means that the first one in the list is the one that has the most impact in your secure score, in this case 15%. In the secure controls, the way it works is it aggregates all recommendations that are related to the specific scenario that you have here. For example, in this case, secure management ports, there are multiple recommendations for this particular scenario. You want to address every single recommendation in order to gain that 15% points in your secure score. As you go over each one of those secure controls, you may see that some of those recommendations also have the quick fix, which will enable you to quickly remediate that recommendation.
Some key takeaways of this demonstrations are: enhance your security posture by address your high security hygiene in Azure Security Center. Make sure that you are always looking at the recommendations and chasing that security score to go up. You really want to do that. Second one is make sure that you use those lessons learned from Azure Security Center Secure Score to incorporate this in the beginning of the pipeline for your Azure governance. You really want to make sure that everything that was recommended by Security Center, you can incorporate via Azure Policy Enforcement, Azure Blueprint, and then you're gonna have not only a strong security posture, but also a steady growth of your Secure Score. Make sure to join our community for more information about webinars, about documentation and upcoming videos.